हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज प्रणव एंड आई एम लीगल इंटर्न इन एक्सिस एंड कंपनी। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट सेक्शन 34 ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट ऑफ 1996। सो द सेक्शन 34 ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन कंसीलिएशन एक्ट ऑफ 1996 प्रोवाइड पॉसिबल कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन अगेंस्ट एन आर्बिट्रेशन अवार्ड और द आर्बिट्रल अवार्ड थ्रू कोर्ट्स ऑफ लॉ। द ग्राउंड्स फॉर सेक्शन 34 ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट ऑफ 1996 आर स्पेशली फर्निश्ड अंडर क्लॉज 2। एनीथिंग दैट गोज बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ सेक्शन 34 ऑफ द एक्ट रिस्ट्रिक्ट्स चैलेंज बिफोर द कोर्ट। So now talking about the grounds that are mentioned within section 34, the Arbitration and Conciliation Act, section 34 contains several grounds on which the arbitration award can be set aside by the court. The scope of the section 34 of arbitration gives courts the courts of law a specific path to follow while considering matters decided through arbitration as reiterated below. The first one is incapacity. The parties to a contract should be capable of entering into a contract. If the legal capacity to the contract is challenged, the same applies to the incapabilities of arbitration agreement as well. The incapability or the incapacity mentioned here could be minority, unsoundness of mind, and basically depicts the situation when a person is not capable of making serious decisions on his own. The second point is invalidity of arbitration agreement. If the agreement on the basis of which arbitration proceedings were conducted was itself invalid, then the arbitration award can not be regarded as a valid one. The next one is lack of proper notice. If one of the parties have not been served with a proper notice of the arbitration proceedings, appointment of arbitration, etc., the Arbitration Act Section 34 allows setting aside of a award. In the case of BSNL versus Messer Nortel Networks India Private Limited, the Appeals Court clarified that there must be a clear notice invoking arbitration setting out of a particular dispute. It includes claims or amounts which must be received by the other party within the period of 3 years from the rejection of a final bill, failing which the time bar would prevail. The next one is the inability to prevent a case. If or not both the parties have been given a proper notice of the arbitration proceeding, both have the right to represent themselves before the presiding officer, which is the arbitrator, of course. If one party is initiating arbitration, appointment of arbitrator, conducting the process through arbitration lawyers, while the other one has no clue of the proceedings, not getting a chance to bring their side of the story regarding the dispute is not a legal process. The principle of audio alteram partem, as we all know, that both parties should be heard, and it is one of the basic general principles of natural justice that is applied in law. So the next point is surpassing the scope of arbitration, after which we are going to discuss composition of arbitration tribunals in question. The Section 11 of the Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996, lays certain rules regarding the appointment of arbitrators. As per the law, both the parties to arbitration need to be a consensus when it comes to deciding over arbitration tribunal, whether it is one or more than one. For example, if in case of international commercial arbitration requires one arbitrator from each country whose parties are subject to dispute and non-compliance of the same, which is furthermore subject to challenge as per the Arbitration Act of 34. So now I'm going to wind up this video, and if you guys have any doubt regarding this, you can just ping me in the comment box and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much and have a nice day.